How to do it?
I'm John Lawrence. You know who this guy is. He's obviously. And of course, it is time for the Lovely Japan Crate. I got this a couple weeks ago. We got this a couple weeks ago, but I decided to wait until Christmas because I figured it would be a nice, like Thanksgiving last month. I figured it would be a nice topper to the day.
Yeah.
If you don't know what Japan Crate is, quick explanation, it is a subscription box service where there are not only three different sizes, but four different kinds of Japan Crates. There's many original premium for the Japan Crate, but you get the premium because it's got all the stuff. There's also Doggy Doggy Crate, which is cute things in Japan. Japan Crate is Japanese snacks. Doggy Doggy Crate is cute things in Japan. Umai Crate is Japanese noodles. And Kirito Crate is Japanese beauty products. But as usual, we're doing the Japan Crate. We got everything sorted out, many original premium. We're going to go in that order. And who wants to start?
You can go first.
I think so. Because I don't have a well fitting hat.
Yeah, that hat's like a couple sizes too small.
All right, you want me to go first, describing or
two sizes too small. You're good. No, I'll show it. You read it.
Okay, yeah, that's that thing. Right?
This one here that looks the like plums.
Okay. Sakuranbo no Uta. These cherry drops have a unique, smooth cherry taste with a small hint of creamy goodness reminiscent of a holiday cherry pie with a daub of whipped cream.
Hmm.
Make sure to try one after eating a real holiday cherry pie to see how close it tastes to the real thing. I don't like cherry pie.
Yeah, it's the worst character that friggin' beer and board games ever came up with. But anyway.
We're moving on.
I messed up.
moving on. We got open it. Oh,
hi. I promise I haven't had any
thing to drink yet.
No, not yet. No eggnog yet.
He bought some.
Not eggnog.
Not eggnog, but he bought those.
We must smell the aromas bouquet. That smells more like the plastic package. I don't like the smell of it.
I'm just getting that off there. These are balls, as you know what I tell.
And they have that ring around the middle.
Ah, it's a hard candy.
Like what, like lollipops have, so. Smells creamy and fruity. Ooh.
Not really much of a flavor.
It's sweet. There's definitely a mild fruit flavor there, and slight creaminess to it. I have tooth problems. I don't want to crunch this. Did I say you had a creamy center?
Hi!
Oh, this is embarrassing.
You're joining us a little ways into this because my camera's stupid. By the way, this is Japan Crate.
This is Japan Crate for December 2016.
Yes, we've already...
Pop quiz! What are the different kinds of Japan Crate? Go!
There's three of them. Small, medium, and large.
What are the four kinds of Japan Crate? Go!
Premium, original, and mini.
No! The four different kinds of crates you can get from the Japan Crate company. There's Japan Crate, and then there's three others.
Umai.
Umai, yes, that's Japanese noodles.
Oh my. That's the one that was everything's handpicked by George Takei.
there's Doki Doki, which is cute stuff from Japan. And there's Kira Kira Crate, which is Japanese.
But if your Doki Doki box has not come so far, don't panic, right? It's an obscure reference.
I'll boo this man, but
we're farting around here for a minute and a half because my camera ran out before we were able to finish. So
he was talking about creamy goodness.
Yeah,
so,
well, this was the creamy goodness we were speaking about.
Yeah,
go ahead and reread the
Sakuranbo no Uta. Cherry drops have a unique, smooth cherry taste and small head of creamy goodness reminiscent of a holiday cherry pie with the double whipped cream. Yeah,
cherry. I was gonna say. Creamy goodness, not cherry pie, but cherry pie. I made a reference to Blame Society films. It was dumb, so I'll skip that. Anyway.
Probably for the best thing. See that so, original part. I didn't really like these things. These things were like hard candies, like the tops of lollipops. Kind of.
They were, both the creaminess and the fruitiness, were both mild. And it was overall very mild flavor, which is not too bad. So, what's the second item?
The second item is that one right there. I got my thumb.
Okay. Umai wa vegetable salad flavor. Vegetable salad flavor. Okay. Coming from the same creators of Umaibo snacks, these chips have the flavor of a tasty garden salad with plenty of dressing. Share this big bag with those who made it on your nice list this year. Those who got on top of your nice list and made it. I'm an adult.
Was that a section?
I was half expecting for bag eruption, and I did not want that to happen.
That's not pleasant.
That smells like dirty mop water.
God!
I've worked retail. I know what that smells like. With a hint of Funyun.
You still do work retail.
Dirty mop Funyun water. Hopefully it smells a lot better. I mean, it tastes a lot better than it smells. Hey, she even shaped like little Funyuns, so...
Ah.
Actually, the flavor's not bad.
I didn't really...
It tastes surprisingly better than dirty mop water. No, it's actually pretty good. It's got not quite. There's definitely some garlic in there.
Put this somewhere. I don't
know. Onion. I'm getting onion. Garlic, onion. It's kind of hard to pinpoint.
I'm not tasting a garden salad. Although then again, I never tasted a salad. And
anyhow, yeah, let's not go there. The, what I was going to say is that the, I want to say, the closest salad dressing I can think of is Italian, but it's not Italian.
It's Island?
No. Caesar? All right, shut up. You know how there's, like, actual grapes and how they taste and how actual grape juice tastes, and then you have what grape soda tastes like? Let's say that grape juice is to Italian dressing what grape soda is to the way this tastes.
I got a hint of dressing right at the end there.
If that makes any sense.
All right.
And I'm known for not making any, but, you know.
Ugh. All
right. So you read, I show, you tell.
This is really cute. Animal Lesson Choco.
Oh, animal lessons.
Cute and soft biscuits with a melty, chocolatey center that go great with milk. Share them with the children in your family for a fun lesson on animals this holiday season.
So I'm assuming, it just has a picture of the animal and then what it says, what it is. Yes. And they are very cute animals. I'm assuming these are kind of similar to what we had in the late 90s here called Koala Yummies, or what Japan still has, Panda.
Hello Panda.
Hello Panda. Hello Panda. So, I have a lion, specifically a lioness. It's a cute little rendering. Amalgamated words.
And I have...
I can smell the cocoa through the... Let me show the peeps.
I already showed it.
It was on there for like a whole 2 seconds, and it wasn't close. So, it's a duck.
Quack, quack.
Okay. Burr. Excuse me.
Ooh. Oh, that's a little sweet.
Mm.
Oh. Look. This should show you.
I know that chocolate flavor. I just can't place it.
See this bag? This bag, the size of this bag? I'm looking in here.
Well, all you gotta do is this.
Not counting the ones we ate. There's only like 10 altogether in this bag.
Apparently these people are owned by the Lay's Corporation. But I do want to taste another one because I know the chocolate flavor.
I know there's a
shit. And it is bouncing around in my I got another lion! Oof.
Oh.
What do you got?
I got a tiger.
Oh, cool.
Oh man, scrape off the top. So you get the nice inside there. It's just chocolate.
I cannot place that. That
that's a good chocolate.
It's good. It's very good chocolate, but that flavor, it's buried in my childhood, and I'll probably be asleep. It'd be 4 a.m. I go, oh, this or whatever. And
as we all know, chocolate good.
Chocolate very good.
Chocolate very good.
Especially if it is the darkest of chocolates.
All right. Ooh.
But not 100% cacao. You don't want that.
I forgot about this one. All right, it's your turn. Second from the right at the top.
Yeah. Shouldn't we be doing these right to left? I'm just doing whatever anyway.
The headers are on the left.
I'm joking. Yakimo Yokan.
A very
popular treat in the Japanese wintertime. Yakimo Yokan is a roasted sweet potato flavored gelatin dessert. This treat tastes almost like a real roasted sweet potato. See page 6 to learn more about sweet potatoes in Japan. So page 6 is back this way. So I have to miss one. Oh yeah. By the way, KFC in Japan for Christmas. That's a thing. Hold on. Ew.
Yeah. That's
here. Let me because I can reach the camera further. That I don't know how well you can see. That's translucent and very gelatinous. Let me read this blurb here real quick.
I'm going to put this on the plate over here.
Wagashi are Japanese confections typically made from plant ingredients. Sweet potato is the flavor that we're showcasing as it's a premier flavor of winter. Often these tubers are wrapped in foil, then roasted in a shallow pit covered with fall leaves. Once finished, they're transferred from the foil to old newspaper and enjoyed as is. The Japanese sweet potato is so sweet that you don't need any butter or salt. You can enjoy its creamy texture right after being baked. Careful not to burn your tongue. Vendors used to peddle these hot treats from cards. However, as time moves forward, so do the ways that you can buy them. Now, there are trucks similar to American ice cream trucks that sell these warm winter treats. One thing that has stayed the same is they still have a red lantern just like their old food cart counterparts. Okay. Want to try a different way of enjoying your Yakimo Yokan? You can chill this treat in the refrigerator and cut slices for a more authentic experience.
We didn't do that because we didn't know about
that's
that.
That's fine.
I didn't read.
I'm not going to. I don't think we need to spend time doing it. So I have knife, and I'm going to cut this.
This is not going to be pleasant.
Actually, let me cut that in half.
Yeah.
I don't think we want that much of this. For all I know, we may very well enjoy it. For all I know, I might want a barf. I don't know. But
it looks like crystallized barf.
It definitely has a... Do you smell this? It smells like sweet potato. I had some sweet potato earlier with butter. Candy yams. Canned yams. Not candied. Anyway. Now, you know what? Okay, first of all, texture. Cooked yam. You got texture dead on. Maybe that's why they decided to do it as a gelatinous substance. However, there's a portion of that gelatinous substance that I think possibly lends to the flavor, which is not pleasant.
I don't like this.
I'm not a fan of this. I'm going to try to goose it back into its container. Cannot goose it back into its container.
Just put it off to the side of the plate. We might need to play for something.
Okay.
Anyway,
flavor-wise, at first, boom, it's sweet potato. That is a cooked, you know, albeit room temperature, but a cooked sweet potato.
All right, next up, you got to show this one.
Which one?
Oh, this
happy seaweed
crackers. Harvest biscuit matcha flavor. If you're a fan of green tea Kit Kats, these biscuits are for you.
Obviously, someone at Japan Crate's a fan of them.
Your crate includes 8 packs of 4 cookies so that you can enjoy crisp biscuits during your winter break.
Crisp biscuits. That needs to be a band name.
Savor the sweet matcha taste at dinner with a hot cup of tea or coffee.
So eat tea and drink tea. Yeah, green tea. You guys, all right, listen, I don't know. Ooh. Oh, you only need to open one of those. That'd be great. Seriously, Japan Crate, is there some kind of embargo or something with the friggin' wasabi Kit Kats? What gives? It's got Japanese import store. not the good part of it.
Oh. We've had a couple
It slightly
Japanese.
Smells of sea. Like old sea stuff that you pulled out of the ocean and just put somewhere. And tea. There's definitely tea stink.
Just shove the whole thing in. It does make me want to barf.
It tastes like fish food.
And you know how?
When we were growing up, we had fish. I was a child. I was curious. It's what you do when you're a kid. It's like I'm sure someone grew up with a dog has eaten a dog biscuit once or twice. Or several. Not good. I had green tea. Tastes nothing like that, thankfully.
Yeah, that was... Yay. And there's how many? 8 packs of 4. There's 32 of these in the package!
I'm gonna have to take some of those to work and give them out.
Matcha cookies?
Yeah. Hey, there's a green cookie.
Yeah. That was the mini crate. That's $12. Next up is the original S20. And you get to describe this thing. Oh, this sounds fun.
I describe you show. Right?
Yes, because I described last. I'm an idiot. This ought to be fun. Okay.
Sunder. My phone!
Well, this is embarrassing.
Well, this will be uploaded on Boxing Day at this point.
That would be tomorrow.
Excuse me.
And he works tomorrow.
I'm you know what? Screw this mess. I'm just gonna edit everything. I'm just gonna put it all in the hopper and let the computer poop it out. I'm not editing anything.
Good.
Hey, at least we're in HD now. It didn't look HD earlier.
Oh, that's a Earth's fluctuating. Positive.
Whatever. Anyway. Okay. So as I was saying, Sunderman gum. You may recognize the word Sunder from the Japanese character term. Okay. It refers to someone who starts off cold and hostile, but slowly warms up over time, just like Sunder characters. The Super Tart Lemon Gum's sourness turns sweet the more you chew on it. You can chew on it.
So basically, this is a
CS camera. All right,
that's a interesting smell.
Wow, that's like getting punched in the face with a lemon. That's
there's like 5 maybe in here. Here are my balls.
Well, first of all, you gotta have them next to each other, not in front of each other. That's a medical condition you gotta get looked at.
Anyway, these are big.
That's a cheese. And they're kind of powdery. They look white on camera because I have a lot of lights.
Funny thing about yellow, this character yellow. On here, she actually, I don't know if you saw this, but she has like her hair.
Oh, yeah, things. Her hair, like bows. Like, what's her face from.
Lemon slices.
chest. Like, what's her face from, Sailor Moon had, like, the meatballs. She has lemon slices. So.
Well, those weren't meatballs.
Well, you know, whatever.
They're around. Firm and fully packed. Power through the sour.
Holy crap. Okay, it's better. Oh, you just now bit through it? Power through sour. That's a lot of lemon. I had tangy spit.
I nearly choked on.
Not to be confused with the tangy. Remember.
Remember, it's barbecue spit.
All I have to say is Chipotle. Anyway,
you're full of Chipotle.
Alright, here. What's the next one? Alright, flavor wise. Definitely lemon tartness. Definitely some hardcore lemon. Like a pungent lemon, like floor cleaner.
Good lord.
Looks like we got more lemon stuff going up, but
oh yeah, we got at least two more items, I think.
But not sticking in my teeth, which I like. Because I have bad teeth.
Okay, fair enough.
Giant holes in my teeth. Anyway, is it bubblegum?
I don't know. Never had bubblegum.
Hey, it is bubblegum.
They're not gonna swallow it?
No.
You're supposed to. That's what Japanese food
okay,
is.
I'm not in Japan. It's legal here. Carry on.
It's not looked down upon. Monokoshi Wataro. Crispy corn puffs. More corn puffs!
Stop being loud.
Are a popular Nagashi treat. These lightly salted puffs have a salted, quiet crunch, so they're a perfect snack to enjoy while watching your favorite holiday movie.
And apparently they'll paint your house.
These, on the other hand, these Sundance things are a great thing to enjoy while watching a Christmas story, too.
Here's the thing. Look at this. It looks like some kind of seafood. Some kind of slimy seafood. Bottom dweller seafood. Here, I'll open it because I don't want this. Okay. It's not too bad. Kind of like a faint Cheeto.
I think he had something smell on it. This bag is decently packed.
I'm smelling some chocolate. Other ones.
Yeah, your nose is pretty weird.
And that chocolate silk. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry.
The corn puffs. Puffs of corn.
Okay. Initial flavor, kind of roasted corn, kind of like legit corn. But I am so sorry. I do not like the taste of the corn puff after the puffing process. There's a distinct puff process taste. I don't like it. Never liked cheese, and it reminds me of cheese puffs. So if they put sweetness and stuff like that, it just tastes like sweet cheese. Which, eh. So, I'm sorry. Like, I hate cheese balls. I hate friggin' cheese curls and all that. I like, give me some smoking Cheetos or some cheese nips or friggin' Cheez-Its, okay? Don't give me any other mess. I hate them. All right. There's my rant.
Alright.
What's next?
Next one is the middle one right there.
I almost gave you some. This is grapefruit and orange nodo ami. No,
that's grapefruit?
Gummy.
That's grapefruit?
Nobody likes getting sick. During the holidays,
nobody doesn't like Sara Lee either, but that's not the point.
Nobody doesn't like Sara Lee.
That's what I just said! Pay attention! It helps!
Holidays! With a healthy dose of vitamin. You didn't do the real thing, did you? Okay, good. That's nasty. Yeah. We're down to two people instead of three now. Come on now. Anyway, a healthy dose of vitamin C.
Contact therapy! Yeah, okay, yeah.
With a healthy dose of vitamin C per ball.
What?
You can feel good about enjoying the grapefruit and orange hard candies.
I'm an adult! Oh, this is nice.
Individually wrapped?
Individually wrapped. I don't know.
Well, one's yellow, one's not. The one that's not is more than likely the, grapefruit, so.
We're gonna try one of each, huh?
I'm assuming. Well, one said lemon, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so a lemon, obviously the lemon's yellow. And, alright, I'm doing lemon first because.
We just had lemon.
We just had lemon, get that out of the way. I don't want to return to it.
Get it off that thing.
Oh, well, give me another yellow one. We didn't show it to these, of course.
Oh, right.
Sorry, and these are just hard candies. Slightly translucent and pearlescent.
The
pearlescent. I don't know if this is upside down. If it is, I'll show it this way. It almost has like a design like a like a sauce packet from Taco Bell.
We're not gonna try to chew these.
Ooh. That's a grapefruit.
What?
Yeah. Woo! It's ew.
It's kind of got a fizzy tang.
Oh, it's still a band name. Or a game show host name. Hi, I'm Fizzy Tang. Welcome to the room.
I'm gonna get one of these.
Wait, where's the grapefruit and orange? My mistake.
We can read.
Look, what's that one? Fresca. Like Fresca. No problems. This and.
Ah, screw you. No. What was that noise?
It sucked my tooth at me. Yeah, I know the weird sound. I would never be able to replicate that sound again. Unless by complete accident. Like it was in the beginning.
All right. Or someone paid them. It's a little not funny.
Again, pearlescent.
Yeah?
I can't taste anything because that. That tingy fizz. Fizzy tangy fizz, whatever it is.
That tastes a bit of orange. Not much, but.
My tongue is numb. Ah! Yeah, see, there it is. A bit of orange. Sorry.
Good lord, that was terrible.
Okay.
Next up is this. This is gonna be flipped. This is gonna be good.
This is cute.
And Panman Pero Pero Chocolate. These chocolate lollipops are almost too cute to eat.
I know.
Featuring your favorite Anpanman characters. These chocolate pops are perfect for dipping into a cup of hot chocolate.
And in case you're curious, here's the back. Pause to read if you are so inclined.
There's a little peel thing on the back.
Oh, okay. Peel here.
Do be careful because it'll probably fall out if you're not careful. How are we going to cut this up to share among three people? That's a good question.
Mmm, it smells delicious.
That's a good secret.
It's kind of stinky, but it also smells like the wonderfully delicious, Old Hunt's canned chocolate pudding. Alright, what we can do is.
Oh, I thought for a second there you went out.
The camera?
We're fine. We're still
going. No, we're still going. Okay. In case you're just joining us, my camera sucks. I don't know how you're joining us in the middle of a video, but whatever makes your boat float. Alright, we will do this. And do that for the third person. Grab one half of the character face. And there is a design on this stick underneath. It kind of looks like a cross between a pig and Eggman. With, you know, obviously dirt on his face, which is chocolate. But not bad.
Agreed. Not bad at all. That was actually very good.
Oh, and there was this cute little character behind. Like a little penguin girl.
I think that's what it means by the back here, because it shows like a silhouette with question marks around it. So maybe that's
who are you going to get kind of thing.
Okay. Yeah.
Maybe it's a cartoon or something, or a manga, or I don't know.
Also, this face up here at the top, with the giant nose and mouth, actually looks like one of the bonus items we got in one of the previous Japan crates. Speaking of which,
also hold on. There's another character on the bottom here. I don't know how well you can see that. Sorry, go ahead.
Speaking of the Japan crate stuff, we got a Christmas tree yesterday on Christmas Eve.
Yes.
Nice, beautiful white one. All one broke apart.
Anyways, we
had practically nothing to put on it.
Yeah, we had like one. So everything else was in storage. So
I looked through my old Japan crates.
There's a lot of little trinkets.
I separated all the toys and trinkets into a single box.
So you put those on a tree.
It works. I put them on the tree. So thank you, Japan Crate. You really helped make this.
No such little trinkets in this one.
There haven't been little trinkets in these crates in a while. Uh-huh. I think the last one was a little dollop.
Get on the Katamari here. Okay, come on.
So that's the original crates, and that is $20. Now the premium crate, which is $30. And I get to show this. You get to describe this. Okay. Second from the left on the bottom.
The Calpo... No. Calpico Mini.
Calpico.
Light and fluffy Calpico.
Calpico!
C-A-L-P. I'm reading this. Calpico. Excuse me. Minis are a great replacement for ice cream cones during the cold winter. Crunchy wafer cones filled with light, airy chocolate. We've had one of these before. Receive one of three flavors. Vanilla, chocolate, or strawberry. I think we have a chocolate one again.
Yeah.
So, I'll tell you what. I will reserve my half for the other person who's going to be trying these. So, we will... that is a hefty, hefty cinch sack.
What? Never mind. I don't want to know. So, the references this guy makes, I have no idea. And, frankly, I don't want to know.
Here, just do that. Just get a little piece that came off there. I was trying to cut it in half, and it didn't work. So, yeah, I'll just eat a little piece here, too. Get some of this chocolate.
When I was a kid,
fluff.
When I was a kid, when I would hang out with Chuck, sometimes we would go to a store called Flowers Bakery, and every once in a while I would get little like chocolate wafer sticks, and I didn't really like them because they tasted kind of dry. This is how you do chocolate wafer sticks.
Use this stuff.
You put in some effort.
Okay.
So Japan puts in effort.
I shot.
Even strange, they still put in effort.
We just
this is the bonus item for this month.
Okay. It's mystery ball or something.
Kakushi Umedama. Ume is a Japanese sour pickled plum. These start off sweet and slowly reveal a sour ume material.
Interior.
Apparently a great trick to give those who made your naughty list. Okay, let me see.
No smell.
This ninja is a stinky prankster, and he's hidden at least one super sour version of these candies in your bag. The fun part is they all look the same, so you can hand these out to anyone who made your naughty list.
Yeah, they all look the same. So, here, since they all look the same, you pick one, I'll pick one.
Okay. Oh, at least one is going to be extremely sour. We've had variants like these before.
Slightly not. Because... Hold on, no. Put all my balls back in the bag. Okay. All my marbles back in the bag. So, slightly, again, kind of pearlescent, kind of slightly
not really
pink.
Having a smell.
No. I guess that might give it away.
Ah.
I crunch right through that stuff, man.
I did not get a super sour one. Either that, the super sour is rather mild.
I didn't get a super sour one, that's weird.
Japanese pickled plum. Is that what it said?
Yeah.
Pickled plum. Oh, by the way, the DIY kit this month, I forgot to show it. It comes in the original crate. It's supposed to be a magic slime DIY. This does not seem to be it. The back here says... The back here says Corey's Matcha. This is not the same packaging as this.
Let me see. Maybe it was a substitute for it right now or something.
Possibly. We will, of course, do these in separate videos. We got a whole bunch of these. We really
eventually.
Get done, hopefully. All
right.
He's had a lot of days off this week, so maybe we can get stuff done.
We'll see what happens.
Hopefully we can get the stuff done.
Long.
I'm sorry. I forgot.
Long cola gum.
Look at that.
That's a big one. This cola gum is the perfect alternative to an icy glass of cola. Long strip is separated into smaller pieces, making it easier to share after your holiday dinner. Now, I do not like these cola candies or gummies or whatever the smeg they are. Oh, that's another kind of look at this guy. Which that's, you know, that's the panorama.
Oh, we've had these before! Oh, it broke off.
Is bubble gum or chewing gum juice.
Fucking blow. Yeah. Hold on, don't go get no.
It tears pretty easy. It's quite soft.
That smell. Oh.
Look, you want to know what this smells like and probably what it's going to taste like? I'm at least imagining what it tastes like. Take RC Cola. That's a good third party cola. You take that. Or like a cheap store brand cola, one of the two. You leave it in a glass until it evaporates and all the moisture evaporates. And you leave it there for about a week. Then you walk by and that's what this smells like.
Put your mouth on it.
Now we'll say one thing. This actually tastes a lot more like the bottle cap candy.
Ah, yes, I remember those. Those were like the hard candies that were...
like kind of like chalky hard candies that were kind of shaped like bottle caps.
Kind of different kinds of
like
sodas.
Grape, orange, root beer, cola.
Oh,
I think it was a Wonka candy, if I'm not mistaken.
That's good. And finally...
Very, very, very soft and malleable gum.
I like this. It's incredibly good.
This one I can swallow, no problem.
As opposed to like the sour cola sticks that are like covered with specks of beer.
Okay. I show you tell.
Oh yes. Right. I forgot. Okay. Pure gummy Pucci Sankaku lemon.
Pucci.
Pure. That's the
company.
Is one of Japan's most famous gummy makers. These chewy candies taste just like your refreshing lemonade. The small packaging makes it a perfect snack to bring with you on your winter trips.
Alright.
How are you get this open?
Now, speaking of... Now, this reminds me of something. The way this is. Imagine much kind of bigger and longer. There were, like, these... Oh, what was it? Minute Maid I think it was Minute Maid. Kind of like fruit, frozen fruit things. I don't know. They were like not, you know, like frozen novelties or ice cream, kind of whatever. Never mind. I'll just tear it.
Please tell me they're not tiny, tiny things that are like gonna fall all over the place.
So this is supposed to be lemon again?
It's supposed to be lemonade.
Come on, Gordon Bennett.
I know something else that I noticed about Japan Crate. They love their citrus products.
Yeah. Or they don't love them. It's more like that's all they probably get hold of.
Oh, yeah, they probably have to get what they
were. So, in lieu of my rant earlier about the whole Kit Kat issue, I retract. So
they look roughly like hearts.
Well, they're, I think texture-wise, they're kind of more like those nasty orange slices, but you just lick it.
Uh-huh.
I don't like these kind of sugar-coated.
It's sour. Why is it sour?
Is that winter power?
It's starting to remind me of those mystery peeps. Yes, we did!
Okay.
The mystery peeps video, if you hadn't seen it, there were three different mystery flavors. The first two were bland and almost non-existent. The third one was extremely sour.
It was just sour. There was no flavor. It was just sour.
I have soda this time. Last time I didn't.
The jelly part of this. I mean, it's kind of just generic jelly. But the flavor is...
Still better than Bean Boozled. Oh, miles better than Bean Boozled. Bean Boozled was just... Anyway.
Is that it?
As usual, we save the drink till last, because it's like a nice wrap-up, and you read this. It's okay. The final from the bottom.
Okay. Double sparkling yuzu, whichever, and lemon soda, a familiar and refreshing flavor with an unexpected tang. Yuzu, is a popular citrus fruit and... It's what gives the soda a nice citrus aftertaste. What was on the top there?
Some change with company name. Is it? Oh, that's company name.
Maybe it means you get, like, 5 cents in Maine or something. I don't know.
Careful.
Hold on.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. I'm going to tell you what that smells like.
No.
New carpet. I'm not lying. I've been in when I was in Omaha school, they put fresh carpet down, it smelled just like that. You know the smell. You know exactly the smell. That real thin carpet, you know? That really rough, like Berber or something. I don't know what they call it. But, it kind of stank.
So I'm trying to pour this back in.
I was moving the table around when I was gesturing. It's about even.
All right. We got about even.
That's what it looks like. It's like Sprite, basically.
I like the packaging. I like the nice clear, but also kind of squishable plastic.
Excuse me. It smells a lot less. Pardon me. I apologize. When I got it, when you get in here... Doesn't really have a smell.
First, we do a little sip.
It's not bad.
No.
It tastes familiar.
Kick me in the tongue with that one. It was okay to kick.
I want to say it kind of tastes like maybe like an off-brand Sprite. Sorry, maybe a kick.
Yeah.
Kind of
feels like an acquired taste.
Kind of off Sprite. I've had something very familiar to that before.
kind of an acquired taste for me. Not really something I'd go back and have more of. So.
We've been rambling on for over half an hour.
That was the Japan Crate for December 2016. Merry Christmas.
See you in January when this uploads.
What did you like out of this bunch?
I would say the, I like the sour gum. Because that's a ride.
The
sour to sweet
Sun
gum.
Air.
Yeah.
Sun Air.
Sundermon. I like that. Was it these? These were okay. There was another corn thing.
What did you think was the worst out of the bunch?
Probably the lemon stuff.
Yeah, I agree.
Not down with the citrus lemon.
My favorite was easily the chocolate stuff, the cookies, the chocolate lollipop, the cone, the soda gum I thought was really good. The Sundare stuff, you know what? I gotta agree with him. It's a good ride.
It's a good experience. It's like you know, it's like when Avatar was out in the movie theater. You went to go see it. The movie sucked, but it was a good experience.
Are you talking about Avatar?
Yeah. See you next time. Bye.
Thanks in the description below. Like, comment, subscribe. Yeah.
Bang.